Jeremy Jeff.
Before we get started, quick announcement, quick score update. Brandon, the Eagles game kicked off.
Yes!
The Eagles are losing 2-0 already. We'll keep you updated for all the next few months. I can't actually believe that Brandon scheduled her wedding on the same night as the Eagles. Either one of these things happened. Either when you were picking day and time for this wedding, you neglected to look at the NFL schedule. Or you're proving your love for Chris in front of all of us. He is truly your one and only. The Eagles are now number two. Everyone, that we haven't met yet, I'm Dave, this is Jeff. We were Chris's roommates for 18 years. Give or take. 18 years is a long time to share a bathroom with Chris. Brandon, you're what, 4 years in?
Nothing.
You got a long way to go. I hope he's better at cleaning up after himself. All right. Our plan here tonight is to continue to tell as many jokes about Chris as we can until he makes a stop. Does that sound okay with everybody?
Yeah.
Chris, this is what everybody wants. You invite these people. You're asking. Brandy, there will be some jokes about you too. You're married now. You're a teen. If he's going to get it, you've got to get it too. Okay. We got a lot of material here.
So, we don't have the audio visual here, so Chris, you're lucky because we have, you know, some old tapes of you in the helicopter pants dancing to MC Hammer, and Touch This, and Vanilla Ice Baby. That was your music back then. Admit it, you know it does. Okay, so we're safe from that. We won't be roasting you into that level, but let's get started. You know, as far as I'm concerned, it's Chris Cool's wedding day. I can't believe it's finally happening. Brandy, I know you've been waiting for quite a while. So everyone knows that these two love marathons. And I think that's today's the first Sunday in quite a while where they haven't run 26.2 miles. In fact, Las Vegas had a rock and roll marathon here last Sunday, so I was shocked we didn't have the wedding here. After that marathon, as both of you were taking part of that, as well as the rest of the groomsmen and the bridal party. You know, Chris, he's a natural runner. If you think about it, for years he's been great at running up bar tabs. running into trouble, right? You know. And running his mouth off. We know that one. Pretty well. So of course he's going to be a natural runner.
Okay, old story about Chris. Going back to high school, not many of you may know this, but in high school, Chris had his own talk show on the local cable access show, RBTV. Shout out to the RBTV grad out there. You guys are in the back for a reason. Okay? So Chris's show was called The Chris Cool Show. Which is very arrogant if you think about it. I mean, even Jimmy Fallon is the Tonight Show with Jimmy Fallon. The Tonight Show with Chris went right for his own name. So Chris's band on that show was called the Electric Pickle. We were actually hoping the Electric Pickle would be here tonight to reunite for Chris and Brandy. They were about to run number. If anyone knows of the whereabouts of any member of the Electric Pickle, please contact local authorities immediately. So Chris had guests on this show ranging from our own family members to our neighbor to his classmates. So his booking agent was really lazy. And his booking agent was him. This is the Chris Cool Show, he did everything. Unfortunately, the episodes of the show have gotten lost over the years. I really wish we could just here's a clip! But we think Chris is responsible for destroying the tape. We have no proof. Might have happened. May learn someday. If anybody ever uncovers an episode or clip, please post it to social media.
So Chris has a lot of peculiar habits, and by saying that, I mean a lot! So he uses drive-thrus instead of going into the restaurant. Now, this was when he got his license in the early 90s, right? People mostly went in, and it's different than it is today. But even if there was a line line down halfway down the block, and there was absolutely nobody in the restaurant. He still waited in that line. Now, I don't know if that was privacy or what was going on there, but Chris said it's peculiar, at least the two of us. Also, they did something we used to call a drive-by. Now, for those people from Chicago and LA, don't mean drive-by shooting. But a drive-by where Chris would say, let's go check out that guy's house and see if he's there. So we just drive-by slowly, looking through the window and see if he's there. And that was it. So again, Chris, I don't know if it's privacy or what it is, you don't want to confront people, but that was one thing, again, made peculiar that we got. Also, in the public bathroom, we noticed Chris doesn't go to the urinal, he goes into the stall. So I don't know if that's privacy or what that is. And then, for those of you that know Chris well, he's famous for losing things or breaking things. Right? Brandon, you know this. So, you know, from our count, he's lost 15 wallets, 8 phones, and he's broken at least 10 pairs of sunglasses. So, Brandon, you know for Chris, never buy an expensive pair of sunglasses. So, you know, go to Walmart, get that $5 pair because he's going to sit on it or he's going to lose it. Same thing for the iPhone, make sure you get the insurance, right? Because he's going to crack it. In fact, Chris, your phone has a crack screen now. If you're going to have a crack screen, you're going to lose it. That's pretty obvious. So, you know, speaking of losing himself, for those of us who are at the bachelor party, Chris lost himself at the bachelor party. We were at the last bar. He suddenly decided to just walk off and leave the bar and not tell anyone. And about 5 minutes later, we went, where's Chris? Where did Chris go? And we were chased after like a little kid up and down the block. Where's Chris? Where is he? We sent multiple phone calls and text messages, not answered. And all along, he just decided to up and leave and walk home. Now, Brandy knows about this only because there was evidence of this walk home on Chris's body where he tripped and fell at some point. He had a scratch on, or let's try to say a little bit more than a scratch on his nose and his forehead. Thank God for the pictures here, it healed.
Thankfully, he had time to heal. Okay, another story about Chris. Forwarding to college years now. In college, Chris was known by the other members of his fraternity house as the Demolition Man. Why was Chris known as the Demolition Man, you may ask? Well, it might have to do with the fact that a halogen lamp that he owned one day exploded and burned down the fraternity house. No one was hurt, thankfully. But if Chris and Brandy ever had a place of a fireplace, may God have mercy on their souls.
Chris is also the king of butt dials, so anybody here that's in his contact list, I'm assuming 90% of you have been butt dialed by Chris at some point. And actually, he's probably butt dialing someone right now. Chris, are you sitting on that phone with your crap face?
Let's see your phone. Can you butt dial my phone? Okay, Chris says one unique talent not many of you may have seen. Chris stands, holding a drink, sitting on a couch, sitting upright, fall asleep, and hold the drink without spilling a drop. It's an amazing thing to go through. He's sitting there, he doesn't waste a drop. He's got a full glass of red wine, sitting there, falls asleep. It's like he's drinking, and he's holding the drink. Wakes back up, takes a drink, moves on. Amazing. If it was an Olympic sport, he would be famous. Incredible.
So another unique trait of Chris that we've seen, especially from high school, is sweating issue. So it's not just during marathons, but pretty much all the time. Chris, how's the perspiration level right now? You doing all right? So we always like to make fun of him, make reference to a Seinfeld episode where George just stands up, sweating profusely from eating the cup of chicken. So if you see Chris sweating a little bit tonight, just ask him if he ate some spicy kung pao.
Speaking of kung pao, Chris has spent some time in the last years for business in Asia. He most recently went to Tokyo, Japan, which gives all of us the opportunity to close our eyes and imagine what the locals in Japan thought of this giant, tall, pale, red-headed guy walking through their streets. We heard the residents nicknamed him the Ginger Godzilla.
I like the cool zone. Chris also has a bit of a snoring problem. So when Brandy agreed to that phrase, better or worse, a few hours ago, you basically agreed to a lifetime of being woken up by 80 decibels of Chris snoring. Now, I did hear he has a sleeping mask, so hopefully that helps.
So, being at their wedding night, we should fully tell the story of how Chris and Brandy met. You've all heard versions of the story. There are some other details you don't know. So we know they met in a tavern downtown Chicago. There was some innocent flirting at first. Chris bought Brandy a drink. Then Brandy immediately challenged Chris to a 10-mile run. They raced out of the bar. They raced down Michigan Avenue. Chris trying desperately to catch up. When Brandy plays hard to get, she literally plays hard to get. Catch up. It's crazy. Thankfully, she was wearing 6-inch stiletto heels, so she got tight. Chris caught up to her, had her number, and the rest is history. Maybe a slight exaggeration, and how it ever happened.
All right, now on to Brandy. Didn't think we were going to let you off. So Brandy, we're both thrilled to be adding you to the family. You brought so much into our lives thus far. But in fact, we finally can say we know someone from Delaware. Very exciting for both of us. And now for you, we met even some more. Is it my proper to say Delawareans?
Yeah.
Okay, so we know from Brandy and the other Delawareans we've known that Delawareans are always trying to spread word about underappreciated the state of Delaware. So we wanted to impress you. We did some research. We found some facts about Delaware that we want to present to everybody what we learned. Fact number one. Yes, Delaware is a real state. It's not a map. I swear it's there.
Fact number two. Delaware is, of course, home to former Vice President Joe Biden. Fact number three. Delaware is where the famous dog fish head brewery is based. Fact number four, Delaware is home to some sandwiches that ranges the greatest restaurant in the world called Capriati's. There's also a museum in Vegas in San Francisco.
We really wanted to have more than four facts, but that's all we could find. I'm sorry. We tried, but Delaware's Wikipedia page one paragraph at the end of the sentence. Sorry, that's all we got here. Biden, dogfish headed Capriati's, that's it.
So another thing Delaware lacks is a pro sports team. Thus, most residents, like Brandy, root for Philadelphia sports teams, which is another reason to feel sorry for Brandy.
Oh, it's gonna get worse. Quick history lesson on Philadelphia sports team. Except for a brief successful run by the Phillies like 10 years ago, the Philadelphia sports team can best be described as pretty pathetic. Here's a quick joke. Brandy, what do you call a Philadelphia Eagles player with a championship ring? A thief! Because they never won one! Where is the best one you have had before?
Eric was a liar. It gets worse.
John Stanks! You suck!
All right, one more joke.
You're done!
One of the Eagles fans keep season tickets on the dashboard of their car. So they can park in the handicap spots.
They're losing to the Cowboys right now.
No, we're not. I'll take your phone.
Well, another joke for now. Brandy, despite the sports
team, you
took
her out.
You're incredibly sweet, fine. We love you, and you're Chris's perfect life partner and running partner.
So, we know that your marriage is going to be successful because there's no better metaphor for a marriage than a marathon. And, you know, the two of you are pretty amazing at marathons, so that's a perfect primer into a wedding. There you go. One thing I do want to say, though, Brandy, you do know what you're in for, right? You do know. And I'm going to say this for myself, for Dave, and for my parents over here, that we're really glad there's somebody to take care of Chris now. Because of everything that Dave and I have said here, he doesn't really do a good job of taking care of himself. So thank you very much.
Aww.
And let's all toast. Brandy and Chris giving the ultimate race of their lives. Brandy, you are officially the newest school.
Thank you, Jeff and Dave. What a nice round of kind words from our friend Dave and Jeff.